Our next step would be importing the jkuplot JavaScript code into our project. We will not integrate it directly to database, nor we'll go for creating the model first. What we'll do is, we'll try to display the chart as it comes from the jkuplot documentation. We'll try to display that chart in our MVC project first. So that is, we'll import everything as such and see whether it works or not. If it is working, then we'll move to the next step of integrating it with database. So let us see how we can do it. To just recapitulate, what we have at present is, we last time we added two bundle config. The bundles were added. Then this is our home controller, which is there. We added a view also to that. Then you have layout.cshtml. This is what we have added to it so far. The bundles for CSS, bundles for JS. This ordering is very important. jQuery must come before the JS files of JPlot. And let us see now, this one is empty, where we have to bring that code. And this is the web.config. We can set it to true so that in case we need debugging, we can do it. So we are closing it. So basically what we have to do is, we have to import the JavaScript code into this index.cshtml. There can be so many views in this project, so there is no point in putting that JS code into the layout file, because otherwise it will get generated for each view. So what we want is that JavaScript code should only be included if this view is being shown. That is a different thing if we are going to show the same chart on all pages, then of course that code should be added to the layout page. So here we'll add the JavaScript code, and let us now have a look at the JavaScript code, what it is about. This is the code that we have to import. What we'll do is, we'll view source and from there we'll copy the JavaScript code. That is a better approach. It might not copy properly from here. So right click, view source, and get it maximized. And here we'll have to just look for that. That is the code. Here it is. Script. Copy it up to the end of the script. So we are copying the entire script tag. We'll come back to our and paste it there. So this is our view, and let us paste it here. So this is what we get in our view here. Next, now let us go back to the source again. We'll look at the source here. This is the source file. We can see one thing, that there is some reference to a double quote chart one. So generally in such plugins, a element with ID is generally manipulated. So we can just have a look at the top. Here it is, dive ID is chart 1, style is width. So this is the one which is probably being manipulated by this jQuery code. And it is the inner HTML of this chart that is probably being manipulated. So we'll copy this and also bring it into our project. So just below this, we'll paste it. Paste it here. Format it. And now let us run it and see whether we are getting the output or not. Okay, the output is there. This means we have been able to generate the chart with the values that were preloaded, and we have been able to import it correctly. Now our next step is to bring in the model or the view model and generate this code from the database. So let us start doing that. Coming to the Solution Explorer, right click on the models, add class, we'll call it C chart data, and click add. And here we can add the three properties, one for the year, one for the S1 value, and one for the S2 value. So this one will be string year get set, string value S1 get set, string value S2 get set. So our model is in place. Now we'll come to our controller. Here we'll generate a collection of the model objects and pass it to the view. We can definitely import data from a database, create a table there, and fill the model accordingly, or use its generated model for that. But to keep the things a bit simple and to make them a little bit fancy, what we'll do is we'll generate the values randomly and then display on the chart, so that whenever the chart is refreshed, it generates a new picture. So let us do that. This is our list of C chart data objects. Then we are creating a object of the random class, and we'll be generating 10 random points. ls.add new C chart data, and to this year we are adding 2002 plus I, because they are from 2002 2003, so I is 0, and so 2002 then 3, the series will be maintained. Then s1 values are between the range 1 lakh to 2 lakh, and they'll be randomly generated. Random class has a property called r.next. It generates a next random number between this value and this value. Similarly, we'll do for S2 also. And finally, let us right click and resolve it. So once it is resolved, we'll now have to pass this list into our view. So as far as our action method is concerned, it is complete. This list is being passed to the view. And now let us come to our action, to our view. And here we'll have to write @ small model I enumerable. So it is an I enumerable of C chart data objects. I'll have to write the full path. So what is the full path? It is jqplots.models.cchartdata. So this is the line for my model. So here this is my model that is coming as I enumerable. So all I have to do is to set these S1 and S2 from the database. I'll just make small scrolling here. Okay. So I can see this one, that this inner is looping. So what I can do is I can write here @ for each where v in model and here. So here I have to generate each of these. So I can write @ string dot format. So what will be formatted? This 0 comma 1. So 0th value is the year. So v dot year, and the other is s1, v dot value of s1. So it is this that has to be generated. So I can remove this portion. So if we set it right, then this one will be the opening bracket, here it will close is here, for each loop it formats it. I'll have to put a comma here. So the entire thing will be generated correctly. The only thing that we are probably concerned about is that the last one will also receive an extra comma. So for example, if you want to generate values like this 2001 comma something, this comma 2002 comma something, then at the last value an extra comma will stay because of this. Actually JavaScript and both C#, they ignore the last comma in arrays. So even if it stays, we don't have to worry about it. C# also ignores it and JavaScript also ignores it, because they'll know that these values are normally generated in loops, and compiler level ignoration is better, because developers otherwise have to spend a lot of time just trimming off the last comma. Some code has to be written for that, so it is better that it is ignored at the language level. So this is what we get. We can, on the same line, just copy it around, copy and paste it here. The only thing would be S2 here. So this is what is the modified code here. You might be wondering whether we can put your MVC code into a JavaScript function. No worries, because at the end of the day, what is plotted is what is coming to the browser, because plotting is at the browser end. So if you can write sufficient code of MVC from the server end and just return the correct JavaScript, then it is the JavaScript that will be interpreted. So therefore this is perfectly fine, and this is the trick down here. Let us run it and see it. So this is the code. I am refreshing it, and let us refresh it. At the moment we refresh it, refresh again, it generates a new chart every time. So this is how we can mix JavaScript with MVC code and generate dynamic charts. You can practice with other charts also, and in 99% cases the only first two lines have to be changed. The remaining is up to you, how you bring this data from the database and whether you generate it dynamically or randomly, that is a different story. So this is a simple exercise that we did, and you can use it in your projects as and when you need it.